So I was playing Path of Exile the other day when I came across an old item whose artwork I've loved since release. So I thought, let's be a real artist and steal this idea. Let's make our own wand in Cobra style. In this series, we will cover the full process from our first vertex to a textured model. But for this, you need at least some Blender fundamentals. So if you are a complete beginner, check the link in the video description to my free course that will teach you the basics of 3D modeling in Blender in no time. Alright, let's steal some art. Like any artist, we start by assembling a collection of references, from which we steal ideas and sell them as our own. For this, I use PureRef, which you can download for free. It's just awesome. Drag and drop images into your board and done. So let's go through some known sources and collect everything we like. First of all, Pinterest. I need some pictures of a cobra from different perspectives and maybe some pictures of a magic wand. Okay, that was not very satisfying. Let's try Google Images. And we wouldn't be a real artist if we didn't have at least one AI-generated image. Let's go to Discord and instruct our good old friend Leonardo Migiorno. Let's try... Imagine a walking stick carved into a cobra head at the end with ornaments and gemstones as eyes. Realistic, photo, wood. Well, this is not a cobra, but it looks nice. Next try. I like these carvings and ornaments. This is exactly what I was looking for. And let's generate some concept art to give us some ideas for the general shape. Quite cool, huh? Who needs concept artists anyway? Okay, in the end, our canvas looks like this. A few pictures of cobras, a few wands decorated with ornaments, and a few general shapes of wands. The first step is to create a 3D model with the proper shape that we can use as our base for sculpting. And we can achieve this in just a few steps by utilizing two awesome modifiers. Let's start very unusual this time, with a circle. The circle is the cross section of our wand, so we want to create an interesting shape. Move a few vertices to the center and then let's smoothen the whole thing once. Adjust the settings at the bottom left by your desire. And now it's time to screw things up. With our circle selected, add a screw modifier. In the properties, just increase the screw value and check that the correct axis is selected. You can also change the angle for finer adjustments. And before you apply the modifier, increase the steps in viewport to give your wand a little bit more vertices. By the way, throughout the video I will not go into detail on the modifiers I use. If you want to learn more, I have a full series where I explain the different modifiers in detail. Check out the video description. Now we need to create the upper part of our wand. For this, we need to clean up the shape and fill the upper hole. Let's extrude the upper loop and then use Loop Tools, a built-in Blender add-on, to turn it back into a circle. If you don't have Loop Tools activated yet, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and search for Loop Tools. Make sure to enable the checkbox. In the Edit tab, you will then have a drop-down labeled Loop Tools. Here we will use the circle function while we have the upper loop of our geometry selected. Now that our circle is round again, we can fill the geometry with a nice topology. And since our circle has an even number of vertices, the default value is 32, this is pretty easy. First, extrude the loop with E and press S immediately to extrude inwards. Then select two opposite edges and press F to fill them. And when you select one of the side edges, you can press F as many times until the hole is filled with quads only. Add some loop cuts for more topology, and with the interfaces selected, click on Smooth Vertices again. And add some loop cuts to the upper part so that the quads are about the same size as the rest. And what we forgot at the beginning is to adjust the size of our model. Right now it's about 48 meters high. Let's bring this down to about half a meter. And don't forget to apply the scale with Ctrl+A. Time for the second modifier. This time we will use a curve to bring our wand in a cobra-like shape. Create a new Bezier curve, Then go into edit mode of the curve by pressing tab. You should see these handles now. Select both points and rotate the whole curve by 90 degrees on the y-axis. To better understand the curve, turn on normals and the viewport overlays. This way, you can see the direction of the curve, which will help you to choose the correct axis in the curve modifier. We want our direction to go from bottom to top, so you can select all points again and click segments, switch direction. Now scale it down to match the size of our wand. Remember, still in edit mode, still both points selected. And with that done, you can finally add the curve modifier to your wand. Select the curve and the correct axis, in our case it's the z-axis. If this did not work, delete the curve and start over, step by step. But it should have worked. You can now go into edit mode of the curve and start adjusting the shape of your wand. And if you need additional points, select two points and click on Segment Subdivide. Okay, beautiful. We can now apply the curve modifier and delete our curve. To form the Cobra hood, you can just scale two opposite vertices with proportional editing turned on. Select two opposite verts, edges or faces and press SX to scale in the X-axis. With the mouse wheel, adjust the radius of the proportional editing. And you should end up with a nice cobra shape. You can further refine the shape with proportional editing, or you can leave it for sculpt mode. The last thing left is the hole on the bottom side, but you should be able to do that yourself now. I think we ended up with a nice shape and good topology to start sculpting now. You know what? Let's also make the bottom part a little bit more interesting. Something like the handle of a sword would be nice. So I will smooth the vertices and play around a little bit. Perfect. To make it even more interesting, let's bring in a little bit of asymmetry. Let's deform the bottom part a little bit to make it look more snake-like. And these are exactly the little things that make a 3D model interesting. Enough talk, let's start sculpting. I'm joking. Before we go into sculpt mode, let's apply the rotation and scale and check our normals by turning on face orientation. This is something you should definitely make a habit of, because as you see, our normals are pointing in the wrong direction. To fix it, we can go into edit mode, select all by pressing A and press Shift N to recalculate them. You can turn off face orientation now and we can finally start sculpting. In the first stage of sculpting, we will only take care of the shape of our wand. No details and no fancy dancy stuff. And by the end of the first session, this is what our Cobra wand looks like. Let's start by smoothing out some parts I don't like, before going into dynamic topology to refine certain parts. For this, hold the Shift key while using your brush or select the smooth brush. Okay, to start sculpting the head, we need to increase the resolution there. My way of doing this is to take the draw brush with a low strength, turn on dynamic topology with constant detail and a resolution of about 40, and then simply click once on the areas where I want to add polys. Okay, a resolution of 40 seems to be too low. Let's try 160. Much better. I also turn off dynamic topology after increasing the resolution, simply to not increase it overall accidentally and end up with millions of polys. The first brush I use when sculpting the shape is the grab brush and the snake hook. They are very easy to control and thus very fast to work with. But the more you go into detail, the less viable they become. I would advise you to try them out both and master them, because they are very, very essential. And you know what? Let's hide all other brushes so you have an overview of the most important ones. With these 8 brushes and the 2 mask tools, you can do 99% of all the things. I will not go into detail for every tool I use. Sculpting is something you just have to experience. The more you practice, the better you become, and there is also no shortcut, no special brushes or anything. However, you can speed up your learning process by watching other people sculpt. I will skip most of the sculpting process here since it would make the video too long. The first sculpting phase took me about 1 hour. If you're interested in watching the full process, as a Patreon supporter you have access to all my videos uncut and you can watch them in any speed you like. Let's add a pair of eyes so that we can fix the position of the eye holes. For this I use a UV sphere and add a mirror modifier with my wand as the target. Back in sculpt mode we still have a lot of things to do. Remember, we are still at a very low resolution. The finer your resolution gets, the harder it will become to sculpt the shape. Time to learn masking. With the box mask, I will select an area to better sculpt the belly without affecting the rest. And you can clearly see that I have too few polygons, so time to add some dynamic topology. The settings are the same as before, just turn on the checkbox. Let's try it again. The black areas mean you cannot sculpt there, so we have to invert the mask. And with the draw brush I will make a fat belly. But sculpting on the front side also affects the backside, because this part of the cobra is too thin. We have to turn on one additional option to prevent this. In the brush settings, open advanced and check the option front faces only. Now only the visible faces will be affected. By the way, don't forget to always adjust the radius and strength of your brush according to your needs. The shortcuts for this are F for the radius and Shift F for the strength. And when you're done with the mask, remove it by clicking on mask, clear mask. And again some smoothing. Time to add the bottom jaw. For this I will just use a plane, which I will mirror in the center with the Addon AutoMirror. As for loop tools, if you didn't install it already, do it now. And then click on AutoMirror on the X-axis. In edit mode we have to create something that looks somehow like a jaw. And thanks to AutoMirror we only have to do this on one side. Add additional topology with loop cuts and extrude the whole object to give it thickness. This should be fine, it will look like a jaw when smooth. Bring it in position and go back to sculpting. I will leave this as a separate object and only combine both later. And don't forget to apply the mirror modifier. Back in sculpt mode I will use X mirroring since the jaw is a rather symmetrical part of the model. And again, smooth and use the grab brush to bring it in shape. Using the draw brush, I will now shape the inner mouth. Here you can hold down Ctrl while using the brush to push the words inside. So simply the opposite of what the draw brush normally does. The same now for the upper jaw. In order to sculpt the other objects again, you have to switch back to object mode, select it and switch back to sculpt mode. Yeah, it's annoying, but still better than combining both objects. And I can easily go into object mode and move the parts separately. I want the mouth to be more open, to look more aggressive. Alright, now let's finish the shape of the head so we can combine the bottom jaw with the rest of the body. Now we need the third essential blender add-on, wool tools. When you installed it, select both your objects and, like the last add-on AutoMirror, you can find the wool tool as a drop-down below. Click Union and your meshes are combined. After using wool tool to combine meshes, you have to remesh your whole model in order to make a sculptable topology again. Because even if your meshes are combined now, the topology isn't. In sculpt mode, click on remesh, select a suitable voxel size. In my case I will try 0.002 first and click on remesh. I think this voxel size is perfectly fine to go one step further into sculpting. So now we can continue to sculpt smaller shapes like the inner mouth. And some parts require even more topology to continue, like the eyes. Here we can use dynamic topology again to increase the level of detail. For this, I'm going up to a resolution of about 1200. And with a higher resolution, I can also continue with the bottom part, which starts to look not suitable for miners. For the final step, let's stick a gemstone in the non-miner part of the... God damn it, this looks like a toy with a vagina on it. Never mind, I will use a cube with a subdivision modifier to give it a round shape. Place it in the... you know what I mean? And sculpt around the gemstone to make it fit. Alright, this is it for the first step. Our Cobra bond slowly comes to life. In the next part, we will sculpt the details before I show you an awesome way to create braided leather wrappings. We'll be right back.